class. In this class, we'll discuss about the stability problems in the suspensions. So before going to the different stability issues, stability problems of the suspensions, we will discuss about the Stokes' law. Basically, the Stokes' law explains us what are the different factors which affect the rate of sedimentation. As we discussed earlier, the major problem in the suspensions is sedimentation rate and cake formation. So this solid insoluble drug particle basically sediments down. So the rate by which this particle sedimenting is the major issue. So what different factors affect this rate of sedimentation is simply explained by Stokes' law. So let's imagine a solid mass is freely falling. So what different factors will affect it? Number one, the size of this mass. Number two, the resistance posed to that particle which is falling down. Number three, differences between the densities. If it is freely falling in the air, then the density of the air and the difference between the density of the air and difference between the density of that particle. And number four, viscosity of the fluid in which it is falling. So Stokes' law basically explains us all these factors: radius of the particle, then differences in the densities, then gravity of the particle, and then viscosity of the particle. So Stokes' law can be understood by a simple formula: V stands for rate of sedimentation, 2R square into D1 minus D2 into G by 9 eta. Here 2R square stands for radius and D1 minus D2 stands for differences in density, G stands for gravity, and N stands for, or eta stands for, viscosity. So all these factors are very, very important in understanding the stability of suspension. If you want to, or if we want to impart the stability in the suspension, we need to work out on all these factors. First is radius. So smaller the radius of the particle, greater will be the stability. So as you know, the particle's radius or the particle's diameter is bigger, then the gravity acting on it will be the bigger, will be larger. So in turn, the rate of sedimentation will increase. So the first step, first, if you want to increase the stability of suspension, you need to reduce the particle size. So that's the first step. Second step is the density differences. So differences between the dispersed phase and dispersion phase. Density difference between dispersed phase and dispersion phase. If the differences between the density of a dispersed phase and dispersion phase, solid insoluble drug and the liquid vehicle is more, then the rate of sedimentation will increase. Then the particle moves much faster. So what we will do, we will add thickening agents in order to impart density, or in order to increase the density of the continuous phase. So if we can manage to reduce the densities between dispersed phase and dispersion phase, then we can successfully overcome the stability problem in the emulsions. Then we have the gravity issue, and the gravity is directly proportional to the diameter and the radius of the particle. If we are going to reduce the diameter and radius of the particle, then definitely the gravity is going to decrease. At last, all these things, radius, differences in densities and gravity, are directly proportional to rate of sedimentation. So if they decrease, rate of sedimentation will decrease. If they increase, rate of sedimentation will increase. So next important point is viscosity. If the viscosity of the continuous phase is more, then rate of sedimentation is less. If the viscosity of continuous phase is less, then rate of sedimentation is more. So rate of sedimentation is inversely proportional to the viscosity. So in order to decrease the rate of sedimentation, we need to increase the viscosity of the continuous phase. So this formula, Stokes' law, explains us, gives us information on all the factors which are affecting the rate of stability and helps us in overcoming all the issues which are reducing the stability and rate of sedimentation so that we can overcome. So what are those? Reducing the radius of the particle, reducing the diameter of the particle, reducing the gravity acting on the particle, decreasing the differences in the densities, and increasing the viscosity will help us in improving the stability of the suspension.